Well, you mentioned Sparta. What other communities do, and Steelville, what other communities do have recycling programs?
Winchester does, and Steelville, Sparta, Redbud, and then of course a lot of those, like say Mulch and shit, a lot of those people bring stuff to Sparta, so there's a lot of smaller communities don't have their own specific recycling. Evansville does. But so like Shoe Line and Walsh people either take stuff to Evansville or they'll bring it to Sparta. And so that kind of helps too. I know Percy quit theirs. Let's see who else we have to talk to. You know, St. Mary's, I think, still does. There's part of our little area here. And that's all I can think of off the top of my head. Those Sparta, Steelville, Chester, Redbud and Evansville are bigger ones. They take more items than the other smaller communities. But something's better than nothing. I don't think anything anyone's willing to do.
Yeah, I know back in the day, like Ruma, Colderville, and Tilden had.
Well, Tilden doesn't anymore. Ruma, I thought they'd been in there, but they might. I don't really remember, to be honest.
Okay, I think we've got time for one more question.
Can I ask a question?
Sure.
All right. So, first, thank you for this. This has been great. I've been excited since Mike talked to me about this. And I just been, So, this has been a fun experience and got me excited about different things again. Hopefully you'll think and be thoughtful about your purchases or things you do with what your stuff or the stuff that you have. If you're going to toss it in the trash, maybe think about it. So hopefully, I felt hopefully a little bit today. So if anyone ever has any questions, he has my number. You can always call me and we'll try and figure something out. If you want to start any other recycling, anything, any programs, whatever, you come up with an idea or suggestion, I'm always open for new ideas and suggestions, especially from younger people, because it affects you a lot more than it's going to affect us. What happens in the next 20 years or 30 years or whatever. So I just want things okay for all of you.
Let me ask, I know it's not part of the regular program, but and I think you did one few event type of recycling, electronics, tires, hazardous waste. Do you have anything like that planned in the near future?
I don't. The electronics, to do electronic recycling is an expense, which is fine. Not saying that's not a reason to do it, but it's just finding the right people to come and do it for you, because there's no one right in the area. Like Edwards, they use someone from Edwardsville, for example. You have to find a date for everyone and set up the program. Tire recycling, someone did one a couple, and they just contacted me, and I just spread out the word. And then that was in Waterloo. I did that there. And as far as the other one, like your fluorescent bulbs and your paint and your spray adhesive things and all those weird different things, the EPA has recycling, but you have to play usually like a 10-year waiting list for them to come to your town. We had one, Mark Moore set that one up. Did you help with that?
No, I did.
Shooting complex.
No, I did not. Yeah. Okay.
And they actually did a whole, so they had a section for recycling, or electronics, section for tires, and then the EPA had all kinds of different stations set up for your paint cans and your spray paint and your fluorescent bulbs, which that's another one I have a hard time throwing away because I have nowhere for them to go. I don't have a place to store them, or I would until we can do another EPA thing.
Well, actually, Home Depot takes stuff.
Yeah. I had no idea. Can you bring them from anywhere?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, well, they get you in the store.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Particularly the bulbs, the new energy bulbs.
Okay, all your LEDs and stuff.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. See? He's always full of information and knowledge. I didn't say what happened, I just said. But, no, it's good to, I'll put that out there for sure. Because with offices that I clean, they all have the fluorescent bulbs. So, and they just, so that's great. It's an easy fix. So again, knowledge, communicating your information.
Okay. Anybody else have anything? Okay, Ms. Heather, thank you for showing up.
Great question.